Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and I can explain almost all the parables, but no customers, because gospel is for 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. So the other people will call me heretic, because this is not a common exposition. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by Jesus, the First Anointed Christ of the Most High, Living God, Elohim, which we call Parbrahm or Allah, that dwells within us, called Emmanuel. God is with us. He was the first anointed light from our Father. And Satguru, which stands for Christ, Nanak, the second anointed and greatest of all the Christs, because he had to confront the kings and emperors of darkness, of Khatri tribal people, against the people of Judah tribe, the princes of darkness that Jesus confronted. He came in 1469 and preached gospel to perfection through the five more lights for 150 years. Still, the darkness could not be comprehended. Then our Father himself came in the name of royal king, Sache, Patshah, we call him Punjabi, Gobind Ji, with his consort Holy Spirit, in the name of Maha Devan, to sort out the stubborn sons of Satan with sword power. Sons have no authority to take the life, but our Father and his philanthropic soldiers, Khalsas, the Puritans, do have. So, Gospel according to Saint Matthew 4, verse 1 to 11. This is interesting, because here the Satan try to allure you away. So what type of tricks he use? Then the spirit of man led Jesus into the desert to be tempted by the devil. Now you know that people, you know, would meditate so that they have desire or longing for God, and some meditate very hard, 40 days fasting, you know, and not drinking anything, just, you know, and Jesus did the same, you know, longing for our God Father. That's what the outer circle temple, you know, temple, outer temple was designed for. For prayer and fasting, which the rabbis let the cattle dealers, money changers to come and set up their shops instead of religious, purely religious prayer and fasting. So that's why Jesus beat them up, because that was the house of his heavenly Father. Heavenly Father is this one, you know, of Yahweh. That's what his name is, Yeshua. Made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, Shua mean Adam. So that's why he, what applied to flesh, the opposite to spirit, the spiritual God, which is Most High, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, in that one, if somebody hit your one cheek, we present the other. But in this one, opposite. you drive them out with a whip, beat them up. The traders who had occupied the court of the Heavenly Father of Jesus, Yahweh. Then the Spirit led Jesus into the desert to be tempted by the devil. After spending 40 days and nights without food, Jesus was hungry. Then the devil came to him and said, "No, when after this prayer and fasting you develop some spiritual power." So the devil came, you know, to him and said, "If you are God's son, order these stones." Stones mean the simpletons, the once born simpletons, to turn into bread, as these new rabbis, the hireling dog collar priests, do in churches. You know, these, to get rid of these priests, you know, which are in churches. Jesus gave his life as the Lamb of God. But they came up because the evil spirited temple priest entered the church of God with Torah under their armpit, and they created the same situation as in the temple, even worse than that. So they made the church worse than that. That's what Matthew 12 verse 43 to 45 states. The situation became worse than before the arrival of Jesus. These people, hireling dog collar priest, they take money out of the donations. At the end of the month, they dip their hand into the church donations and take it as their salary. And that's what Judas Iscariot was doing. Whenever he wanted, he will dip his hand into the purse. And he was a thief. And so are these dog collar priest thieves. And you should be we are royal priests. Royal priests have fellowship. They don't need a priest. That's why the tax collectors and other, you know, who are sensible people, when they found that the rabbi is useless and corrupt, you know, he doesn't know anything, they know better than him, they stop going to the synagogue. When they stop going to synagogue, then because it was the law of the rabbi that they should attend it, so for transgressing the law of the rabbi, he called them sinners. But they were sensible people. So when Jesus was preaching, it was they who listened to Jesus attentively, which they called sinners, because they won't attend their synagogue, or they were atheists, you know, and seeking a spiritual food which Jesus provided. But Jesus answered, "The scripture says, human beings cannot live on natural bread alone." Natural bread, you know, you eat and you shit and you piss and all that, like animals. What's the difference between that person and an animal? Animal also eat. They also drink water, and they just grass. The next day again, the same thing. So no difference between man and animals if you do the same. But this is the golden chance for the people. This is the age of Christ, age of sun, primary source of light, that you should try to earn your own salvation or rest by preaching gospel, expounding and all that. So do not waste your human birth. Is very hard to get. You could have been, your soul could have gone into an animal or anything, you know. So you are lucky to be born as a human being. And if you have common sense, then exercise it to glorify our Father. So the scripture says human beings cannot live on natural bread alone, just eat and it come out from the other end, but need every word that God speaks. Now Jesus was the Son of the Most High. Sons are representative of the Father. So Jesus represented our Father, God. Whatever he wished, Father allowed him. That's why he was omnipotent ambassador of our supernatural Father, Allah, Parbrahm, Elohim. So speaks the spiritual bread for your mind. You need a spiritual bread for your mind. And that is what Jesus came to provide. Then the devil took Jesus to Jerusalem, the holy city. You know, they put on these robes, long, set him on the highest point of the temple. And it is the, when in Jerusalem, Jesus was preaching, the most great enemies of Jesus over there were the temple priest. They did not like him. They call him heretic. They call him all sort of things, you know. So that is what they were doing. Then the devil took Jesus to the Jerusalem holy city, set him on the highest point of the temple. That means pinnacle. And said to him, if you are God's son, throw yourself down, for the scripture says, God will give you orders to his angel. God will give orders to his angels almost about you. They will hold you on with their hands so that not even your feet will be hurt on the stones. It say, you know, stones mean that you won't be hurt. If you do the will of our Father, Father looks after you. And we don't test our Father, you know, because when you get his word through logical reasoning, when you get this his word through logical reasoning, then your heart knows that that's true. There's no, it's 100% true. It's the bottom line truth. And again, people to whom this one is being addressed are the sensible people, twice born. First was about the bread, was to the once-born people, that they should look for spiritual bread rather than just eating the not natural bread, so that not even your feet will be hurt on the stones. Jesus answered, but the scripture also say, do not put the Lord your God to the test. No. Here is a corruption, you know, because in Jesus, we don't have Lord. We have Father and we are his sons. Lords, they have slaves. So, do not put God to the test. We should put God to the test, not to the Lord, your God. This is a Messianic Jews corruption. So, then the devil took Jesus to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms, secular kingdoms of the world, in all their greatness. And say, then he said, devil, all this all this I will give you. The devil said, if you kneel down and worship me, let me look for money. As the Pope is a practical example of that, falling into that temptation. He was the kingmaker, and also he was the great person. Anybody who disobeyed him, he would chop his head off or burn them to death, as they did to the Cathars in France. 150 were burned in the church. Then Jesus answered, go away, Satan. The scripture says, worship the supernatural Father and not the Lord, you know, that have slaves. Your God, and serve only Him, our Father. Then the devil left Jesus, and angel came and helped him. So this is the gospel. Now I can explain it on the basis of Trinity. So that will make it much more effective. This is the simple, simplified form of the Trinity. So the first temptation, there are three type of people. This is once born. These are twice born doubting. Twice born sealed to serve God. And this over here, they are the very sons of God. They are omnipotent. They know everything. So devil can't deceive them. So devil run away from these people. So the once born people, to them, the devil, he can only see. He can't perceive because he has no common sense. So these people who are once born, you see these people putting on robes, Russian one putting on big hat on top, and white one and all that. These people, they put on these devils, they put on these robes. And the simple man, you know, the common man, he cannot ponder over. So he is frightened of them. So he will give them everything, whatever they want. So that is called the turning stones into bread. Stones mean simple-minded people, and they work for you, and you live lavishly. They used to take tithe from these people, but after the death of Jesus told us, you know, the situation will become worse than before. In Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the arid spirit entered the church of God. They were the one who was sacked from the temple after burning, and they could not find another job. So they, let's go back to our old people in the church of God. So they entered in the church of God and established themselves. So they were going for money, collecting money all the time. And they were making the simpleton, once born people, to work for them. Remember that the rabbi and other people, they were not supposed to work. They are not supposed to put their hands at plow, but the other people will do it. You just sit at home and they will give you tithe. So this is the tithe, you know, they are taking in the churches when they dip their hand in the collection or in the donation of the people and steal money from there as their salary. So if they have been working on church, working in Church of God, headed by Jesus, then you would have been rewarded, as at Pentecost, the 12 laborers of Jesus was rewarded with the Holy Spirit. So this is a temptation is to the simpletons, first one, bread. If you are hungry, turn stone, simple-minded people into bread, into your, for luxury living, as they do in the Romania, Hungary and other people, these Catholic people do it. That's the one it is, you know. They run in cars, whereas their paymaster, can't even afford a donkey to ride. So this one here are the twice born. Now this are only capable of social work, social life, meeting relatives and other thing, social, you know, not any thing involving business or clever. So this is the second temptation of Jesus was to those who are twice born. And to him, you know, the devil said, go to the highest point in Jerusalem, that means pinnacle, and drop yourself. When you drop yourself, the angel will come and put their hand underneath, won't let you hurt. So that was the second temptation to Jesus. The third one, political affair. This is political. Here they are the one wise men. They are doubting. They go for God, you know, mostly. Very few go for, mammon, you know, here, and God here. Very few go for God. Whereas those who are sealed to serve God, they are political affair. There's a political affair at the bottom. They like then the winning countries one after the other. So this Pope was the kingmaker in the time of 1,000 or more years ago. He was kingmaker and he was had a great influence, political. So this temptation was to those people. Third one, the third temptation was Jesus answered, but the scriptures also says, do not put God to the test. Then the devil took Jesus to a very high mountain or pinnacle, you know. High mountain and showed him all the secular kingdoms that he can see, you know, with his eye, showed him all the secular kingdoms. And then he said, you know, want to test the God. This is political. Now show all the kingdom and forget about God. Those who are sealed to serve God, he said to them, forget about God. Come and serve me. Let me come and work under me. So that was the temptation to the twice born who were sealed to serve God. Twice born, sealed to serve God. Now these people here are fourth type. They are the one who are resurrected. And you cannot deceive them. So that's why, you know, when the Satan meet these people know the very matters of their heart. So they can't trouble any of these people. So that's why there were only three temptations, not four. If you kneel down, that means in political, to political rule, you know, and worship me, Mammon said, then Jesus answered, go away, Satan. The scripture says, worship the supernatural Father and not Lord. He is not Lord, he is our Father, you know. That have slaves, lords have slaves, you know. This Father has sons. Your God and serve only Him. So Jesus then told him, only get seed to serve God and nobody else. Then the devil of Jesus and angels came and helped him. So that's, you know, the gospel. So you can only tempt three type of people, not the fourth one, which is spiritually sealed to serve God. And here is, I have made a graphic that will help you to all see how these priests are doing. And its description is in the description. I put this link to this table, so you can always print it and see how you understand. So there you are. So there you are. These are the once born, not capable of thinking, not capable of learning anything, but being honest, you know, in the company of the other, they also grow up and work solitary. So this is the table I made, which is interesting, maybe I put down. So this is a bishop, you know, and this dog dog is the priest. He can't raise his ears, not to listen to anything, but whatever the Pope tells him, he has to just vomit that out. Yeah, it's a pity, you know, that it's a mostly learned through face-to-face discussion. So if you are interested, I can give free seminars on Christianity and Sikhism. Our Father God bless you.